الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، التسحير وهو إيقاظ الناس وتنبيههم على السحور. قال ابن الحاج المالكي رحمه الله: اعلم أن التسحير لا أصل له في الشرع الشريف، ولأجل ذلك اختلفت فيه عوائد أهل الأقاليم، فلو كان من الشرع ما اختلفت فيه عوائدهم المدخل. About تسحير, which is to wake up people at night so that they can do the preparation for سحور. Scholar Ibn al-Hajj al-Maliki رحمه الله said that know that tashir has no foundation in the honorable sharia, Islamic law. And this is why the habits of different countries differ with regards to this option that they have invented. So if it was from the sharia, they wouldn't have had different ways of implementing this point. يعني بكل واحد نايم، ذكرنا الناس على السحور، بقول لك 5 دقائق، 10 15 20، قبلها بنص ساعة، ب40 دقيقة بيطلع يطبل ويزمر في الشوارع ويصرخ السحور يرحمكم الله. والله نسيت شو بقول، الواحد بيكون بده ينام شوية زيادة علشان يكون مش تعبان باقي اليوم، من حقه الشرعي ينام شوية يرتاح. ففوق 15 20 دقيقة بوقف السحور، قبلها ب20 15 30 دقيقة بيطلع بيطبل ويزمر. لا إله إلا الله. In many Muslim countries, I'm not sure about all of them, but in some of the Muslim countries that I have noticed, they have something called tashir. Someone goes to the streets at night using drums. Sahur, 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 sahur. Remember what we said before, that they came up with this thing called doing sahur before to make sure. See, you have to make sure. This is Ramadan. 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. A half an hour, maybe, or more, or a little less, those guys with the drums go from street to street, screaming and shouting, wake up. So how much of your night they took, instead of following the sunnah, people are like fixated on this, really. You can, you know, hardly, especially when summer, Ramadan is in summer, you know, the nights are short. So people are working, they finished Taraweeh, alhamdulillah, they need to sleep. So the tashir comes before the imsak. Two words that have brought hardship to Muslims. Because Allah didn't legislate it. Allah did not legislate it. La ilaha illallah. This is what the bid'ah does to its people. روى أحمد وأبو داود والحاكم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا سمع أحدكم النداء والإناء على يده فلا يضعه حتى يقضي حاجته منه. الله أكبر. هذا في السلسلة الصحيحة. قال الألباني: فيه دليل على أن من يطلع عليه الفجر وإناء الطعام أو الشراب على يده أو في يده، أنه يجوز له ألا يضعه حتى يأخذ حاجته منه. فهذه الصورة مستثناة من الآية: وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر، سورة البقرة آية 187. وهذا في تمام المنة، في التعليق على فقه السنة للألباني رحمه الله. إمام أحمد، أبو داود، الحاكم reported that أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه، may Allah be pleased with him, said that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said إذا سمع أحدكم النداء, when one of you hears the adhan, now this is the second adhan, that indicates that the time for Fajr is now. This is the second adhan, not the first adhan. إذا سمع أحدكم النداء, when one of you hears the adhan for Fajr, not the first adhan, and in his hand, on his hand, there is a pot, there is a plate, there is a cup of water or juice in his hand or on his hand, you know, it depends on what is it. فلا يضعه حتى يقضي حاجته منه. He shouldn't place it down until he is satisfied. Either eating or drinking, don't put it down. The adhan is on. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is the one who legislates by permission from Allah, not us. That's what he says. When you hear the adhan and you have the pot, the plate, whatever it is, you have a cup, don't put it down until you're satisfied. This hadith is found in As-Silsila As-Sahihah for Al-Albani or by Al-Albani. Al-Albani said that there is evidence, meaning in this hadith, that those who reach the time of Fajr while the pot or cup of food or drink is on his hand or in his hand, that they are allowed not to put it down until they satisfy themselves from it. So this situation, Al-Albani says, is excluded from the ayah, which is in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, ayah 187, وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ. Eat and drink until it is sure that you are sure that it has become clear. The day, the light of day, has become distinct from the darkness of night, which is what? Min al-fajr, at the time of Fajr. So you keep eating all the way until the second adhan. If you were finished by then, alhamdulillah, you're still having something to drink. You get thirsty, so you're trying to keep drinking water all the way, do it. Don't think this is a Roman thing. The Romans, by the way, when they agreed with something, they said, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahullah, was asked by a scholar, asking a bigger scholar, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, about one of the scholars of Al-Salaf al-Salih, and Imam Ahmad said, good scholar. See? So this statement by Al-Albani is found in Tamam Al-Minnah في التعليق على فقه السنة. Also among the bid'ah of Ramadan, المنادات لصلاة القيام التراويح بقولهم الصلاة جامعة أو صلاة التراويح قياما من شهر رمضان يرحمكم الله. بعدين بقوم واحد يكون قاعد شايف الإمام موقف بدأ الصلاة يمكن أو حيبدأ الصلاة مبالغة يكون ما بدأ الصلاة لكن ما بيقوم الإمام واقف وفي ناس واقفين وراه حتى إيش يقول الصلاة جامعة ولا بيقول صلاة الترويح قياما من شهر رمضان يعني أنت مش عارف إنه هذا شهر رمضان وإنه هاي الصلاة صلاة القيام اللي الناس بيسموها تراويح. Among the bid'ah during Ramadan, innovations in religion is to call for the Salatul Qiyam, which people call Salatul Tarawih. It's Salatul Qiyam. Qiyamul Layl is what people call today a Tarawih. By saying As-Salatu Jami'ah, everybody, let's pray together. That's what it means here. Yeah? Or this is Salatul Tarawih. Qiyaman. So they combines تراويح and قيام in the same sentence and they are the same thing. من شهر رمضان for شهر رمضان يرحمكم الله, may Allah grant you his mercy, as if they don't know that this is Ramadan. Like I said in Arabic, they'll be sitting there, the imam stood up, you know, just about to start the salah, and they were sitting there until they hear, oh, salah, jami'a, oh, they all stand. They don't know that it's Ramadan. They have to announce it, Ramadan, Ramadan. So why you think they're there because it is Sha'ban? They're there because it's Ramadan. They're praying Qiyam al-Layl. أدعو الله عز وجل أن يذهب عنا البدع كلها ما ظهر منها وبطن وما بطن. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from all types of bid'ah, apparent and hidden. والحمد لله رب العالمين.